Our next guest, also from the business sector, recommends specific guidelines and safety standards in preparation for restarting the economy. With us now for more is Ambassador Benjamin Yuhiko, the president of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Good to see you again, Ambassador. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Kathy. It's Benedicto, not Benjamin, but that's all right.
Yes, of course, sir. Is the PCCI satisfied with the manner by which the government decided to extend the ECQ in Metro Manila and other high-risk areas?
Yes, generally, we have been satisfied, actually, with the result the government has produced in terms of fighting the pandemic. As you will see from the statistics, the spread has slowed. We have declining hospital admissions. We have rising rates of recovery, falling cases of fatality, and the social amelioration programs have been in place to soften the blow. So I would also add that as a measure of how effective the Philippine government has dealt with this problem, if you take a look at the U.S., the population over there is 328 million, and total cases close to 1 million as of today, and the total deaths about 55,000. Now, in the Philippines, we have a population of about 105 million. Total cases is 7,192 the other day, and only, quote-unquote only, relatively speaking, very low death rate of 477. Now, if you look at the numbers carefully, you will see that there is a very significant difference, not only in the infection rate, but also in the death rate. And this is a measure of how our government has been effective in fighting this coronavirus problem.
So would you have been ready? Would your group have been ready for a lifting of the April 30 deadline if it wasn't extended to May 15th, given what you said were the conditions that would show success in the government's efforts?
Well, since about 10 days ago, the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry has been actually very actively planning what our members should be doing while we are waiting for the go-ahead for the lifting of the quarantine. So there are quite a number of things that need to be done. I believe that the government has addressed some of these items when they actually put out four categories of how the phasing should be done in the general community quarantine guidelines. However, we would like the government to expand this information a little bit and let business know who will monitor this, who will interpret this, and who will regulate this. So in general, we are quite happy. Although if I look at the guidelines for the GCQ, there are some questions that will arise. For example, in category 4, where there is supposed to be 100% closure, it's indicated that malls, open parenthesis, limited opening, close parenthesis. I'm not sure how to interpret this. Also, in the area of construction, it was included in category 4, which is 100% closure. Frankly, I thought that this would be part of what would be category 1. Infrastructure and construction could be open even as of now. So we are, in summary, we are prepared in terms of our planning, and we are just waiting for the government to issue guidelines and instructions as to when we can actually begin.
In terms of the details, what kind of information did you need in reference to the current baseline and the targeted statistics used to warrant an extension until May 15th?
Well, basically, this would be the number of cases infected, the number of deaths, the recovery, number of recovery, and the non-objective factors like looking at the emergency room capacity in the hospitals. Now, all of this, we have observed that this has been actually on the way down what we were hoping for was an actual baseline, like a grade, that if we are able to reach such and such levels within such and such 2 weeks, then government will say, okay, we will open up. We didn't see that, but we are hopeful that based on this, the general observations, and even the recent comments of the president, we are hopeful that he might be modifying the quarantine guidelines very soon, perhaps even earlier than May 15, we hope.
So the goal is really to lessen the risk of infection and a resurgence. Do you think there's any way around that other than science or data?
Yes. What we are telling our members, for instance, is just in case the quarantine is lifted, we have to emphasize to our employees, to our owners of the business, that they have to continue the guidelines on safe distancing, for instance, and the basic hygiene that has to be continued, the washing of hands and so on and so forth. You know, if in fact the economy reopens, I believe that also the business owners and the employees, they don't want to die. They don't want to do any risk. So they will be automatically following these hygiene guidelines and this safe distancing and whatever other mitigation measures are needed if they want to go back and continue to be in business. Otherwise, if the clients see that a restaurant is not observing this, nobody is going to go to that restaurant and they'll end up closing the restaurant. So this is now the new normal.
Geographic considerations, will they play a major factor in the gating guidelines?
Yes, it should. I want to mention also, for example, that I've been following a study made by the University of Singapore of Technology. And they issue a forecast on when will COVID-19 end. Now, this is a data-driven estimation of end dates based on a lot of factors. Now, they have actually, and they continually monitor the information on all of the countries, maybe about 60 countries as well. And for the Philippines, we see a very, very good trend. Now, I emphasize that this is a forecast, but I'm going to read to you what the report says. I'm going to try to show it to you here, but I don't think you can see the detail. But this graph shows that in their calculation, the 97% of the curve will be down by May 10 of 2020. And by May 22, it will be down to 99%, the rate of infection. So this is just one of the studies that we look at. And again, I emphasize, this is a forecast, although done by a credible university, the Singapore University of Technology and Design. So on this basis, business is hopeful that we will be opening soon.
All right, there's the silver lining there, and we did see the graph there. Thank you so much for sharing that information, Ambassador Benedicto Yuhiko. Stay well, as always.